Two friends and a chat. Two friends and a chat.
Two friends and a chat.
2007, there was a Supreme Court. Let me look this up real quick. It was Supreme Court 2007, Grutter versus Bollinger. They literally, the Supreme Court okayed. There it is, Grutter versus Bollinger. Okayed, was it 2007? Make sure I'm... Grutter versus Bollinger. Nope, it was 2003. I was off by a little bit. But it said that college admissions can use race as a part of the admissions process. The Supreme Court upheld this. So when we're looking at authority, we really got to fucking pause and think before you jump on the side of somebody just because they're in a position of authority. You can look this up. Grutter versus Bollinger. It was decided in 2003. Supreme Court of the United States said colleges can use race as part of the admission process, deciding process. It's racist to use race as part of the admission process. I don't even know how, but they've changed it. They've changed what the definition of racism is now. Racism is something, you have to be in a position of authority or some shit like that. It doesn't even have to do with race. Unless you're white. If you're white in a position of power and authority, then you can be racist. I don't think you can be racist if you're not in a, if you're a minority in a power, a position of power. I'm not quite sure about that. You know, I'd ask some of these people next time. But yeah, that's what they, and I had arguments with both of these women about this. And it's like, you're, and then they're sitting there making fun of people having racism used against them. And I'm like, you're fucking hypocrite here. That you're not wanting equality. That's not what you're going for here, obviously, because you're getting a thrill out of people suffering through racism. But how does this, why, what are you doing? You're being racist right now, and you're a fucking hypocrite. You know, you say you want equality or whatever. That's not what you're getting. It's like feminism. They say they want, they don't want fucking equality. They don't want to get punched in the fucking head if you cross some line with a guy. But that's a reality for men. If there's a certain line you cross, you get fucking punched in the head. That is what it is. They don't want that. They right. want to be protected. You don't ever fucking hit a woman. Right. Hey, it's just the third and fourth wave feminism is crazy. First wave is all fine, right? Open equality. They get to, they get an opportunity every man, every man does. Fine, I'm down with that. Second wave, beginning it was okay. Then they started falling off the rails. Third and fourth wave are fucking delusional. And it's all in these social sciences in fucking colleges, man. They're teaching them this whack-ass shit. Teaching the white people, or you can't be racist against a white person or something like that. It's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Of course you can be racist against white people. It's unbelievable what they're teaching them.
So these girls you was debating with, they're still in school?
Both of them were, yeah. Yeah, yeah, the first one happened a few years ago, and I've been seeing both of them. But I'm not going to allow them. Just, I'm not going to be okay with them saying racist shit.
Right.
I'm not going to just sit back and be a fucking soy boy and like, yeah, I just want to fuck you. You know, I'm gonna, you know, you're being racist and you're being a hypocrite here. Actually, one of them was a heated one, too. The one that happened pretty recently. It got pretty heated. Like, I was pissed off that... And she wouldn't back up. You're obviously being fucking racist right now. There goes again, these fucking lights. I don't know what's up with that battery, man.
Yeah, it's just cold.
Yeah. Yeah, what else was I going to say about the... oh, yeah, and the fucking... as far as the equal rights for women shit goes, they're just delusional about this shit, right? Like, they want the same number of workers in every... Or they want the same number of women in every field, right? Some shit like that's what EOE is all about. They want all the diversity and everything.
Right.
But with men and women I'm speaking of here, the most equal places in the world as far as opportunity goes is Scandinavian countries. And that is the biggest gap between equality of numbers of jobs, right? Like STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, the biggest gap between men and women in those fields is in Scandinavian countries, where they've went the furthest lengths to ensure that any of the barriers based on sex have been broken down.
Hmm.
And you know where the largest gap between women and men, what field that's in, where there's more, way more women than men?
Nursing.
Nursing. because men and women are different. You know, breaking this one to you, 2020, guys, men and women are fucking different. That's why we could do different jobs. It's just unbelievable what they're teaching these fucking people. And they believe it. They come out of there because they've been brainwashed for 17 fucking years. They believe it's the truth. And they're the authority figures. They've you know, the people who are telling them have done the research. They've done the research, you know? Well, who's done the research? Human beings. Are human beings flawed? Yeah, human beings are flawed. So why the fuck are you believing it just because it's peer-reviewed research? Peer-reviewed research. Yeah, I had my human sexuality class. There was this fucking writing prompt. It was on the effects of male sexual performance. Yeah, it was effects on male sexual performance. And this guy was a doctorate. He wrote the article, and he was running this fucking study. And he said, the article said, and the lady who posted it forced a remark on it had a doctorate. So it made it through two doctors' eyes here. Doctors, that's the highest authority I know. They've done all sorts of research between them. I mean, one guy was in head of the research. And he said that sleep was benign with respect to male sexual performance. It said that in the article. I'm not even going to go into that one. It's so obvious. We wake up with morning wood. Shoot. Our testosterones rise when we go to sleep. We replenish our testosterone stores when we go to sleep. Cortisol goes down. Cortisol inhibits or it lowers testosterone because it attaches to it. It's hardly benign. And before I posted this, I went off on this one on the discussion in school. I looked it up to make sure I wasn't somehow fucking this up.
You did your research?
Yeah, I did my research. I did it. Yeah. So, yeah, and the second one was this paper in my neuroscience class when I was doing the gut microbiota. I mentioned this on episode 3, but the microbiota class, microbiota paper. This is a paper written in the decade. It said fat makes you fat. So why don't I care about research? Because it's carried out by humans. Humans are flawed. Therefore, the research is flawed oftentimes. The scientific method is perfect. Those tasked with carrying out the scientific method are terribly flawed. Terribly flawed. So fuck the research. Empirical evidence, anecdotal evidence. When you get a mountain of that, then you start believing it. And then you start looking for the signs of figuring out actually why it's happening, something that matches up with your experiences. But, I mean, what institution in America isn't flawed? What one? What one isn't corrupt? Absolutely fucking corrupt. What one? I mean, leave it in the comments, guys. What fucking institution in the United States isn't ridiculously corrupt? But we believe these people because they're in positions of authority? Fuck the research, man. Fuck what the authority figures say. They're lying to us. It's not necessarily lying to us. Some of it is blatantly. It's definitely blatantly lying. Some of it is just ignorance. They think they know, but they don't. Like this fat paper. It's unbelievable that in 2010 or whenever this paper was, people are saying fat makes you fat. It's just so not fucking true.
So do you think that he had financial gain by saying that?
I know. I've dated a woman who worked in a scientific research center, and she told me directly, and we all know this happens, that they put pressure on her to fudge shit. Like, maybe take the readings a little bit early because they know the drug would do this or that at that point rather than when it was supposed to. Or just fucking, just lie. Just straight up lie on it. I mean, this shit happens. Why? Nobody should be surprised by that. Of course that shit happens. Because money. The best thing about capitalism and the worst thing about capitalism are the exact same thing. Greed. It's the best and worst thing about capitalism. Yeah. Fucking authority figures and research. Oh, come on, man. The fuck are we talking about? What's next? Fuck that. Thanks for watching, everybody. That clip right there came from either episode 5 or 6. Both of those episodes were recorded in one day, and we were able to do that because of all the suggestions and comments on YouTube and Facebook. We pay attention to them. We read them. We comment back. It makes making episodes a lot easier, the content for it. So we appreciate it. Keep it up, and we'll keep videos coming. Thanks. Later.